So right now we're working on robots for environmental sampling. In particular, we're working on robots that can characterize large impacted sites very inexpensively and rapidly. So it doesn't just have to be soils. It could also be anywhere you don't want to send people, you can send a robot to sample and collect information for you and keep people out of harm's way.
Another advantage is we can get more data and higher quality data. It's less prone to human error, and we can send the robot out for hours collecting sample after sample after sample.
In environmental engineering, there's huge value to in-field real-time sample analysis, because right now it takes forever to collect a sample, send it to a lab, get results back, make decisions. We're trying to build robots that can provide that information in real time so that the robot can decide where to go next and to do the job better, sample things faster and more inexpensively.
What makes it different is we have a portable X-ray fluorescent sensor. You can scan a sample and figure out what kind of elements are there. The robot is designed such that it can go in challenging environments, and it also has an arm that helps lower the sensor to the ground, because the sensor has to be almost touching the sample for it to make a valid measurement.
So this sensor has several advantages. First, it's like the sensing time is very short. It can get a result in several minutes. And then another thing is like you don't need a complicated sample preparation for this kind of technique.
The impact of these studies will be better characterization of these sites that will allow us to remediate any contaminants that are in the soil. We've started working with both robotics companies as well as environmental engineering companies to try and transfer some of this new approaches into the field. And those companies have built their own versions of these robots and deployed them at a customer site, which is very exciting to see them actually deployed. One of the unique things about this collaboration is how interdisciplinary it is.
Neither Aaron nor I could do this independently. It has to be a collaborative effort in order to make this work. And I think that is a unique collaboration in that it can only be done in a collaborative mode.
And really, it takes all of these different disciplines coming together to build this kind of complete system. On the robotics side, one of the challenges is just getting through the terrain. And different sites may be rocky or have dense vegetation or sandy soils. And so that affects the mobility and how the robot is constructed.
This project has opened up a host of new opportunities for us doing environmental chemistry and sensing to apply it to various scenarios, not just soil contamination, but it could be tank inspections, it could be detecting invasive species.
I think this research really shows how robots can help us handle different environmental challenges and do so in a way that reduces the risk for humans involved in the process.
I would say that robotics, automation, and AI can improve environmental engineering and remediation.
I think the key takeaway here is that robotics is now at a point where the systems can get over this kind of challenging terrain and really perform useful work and help keep humans out of these challenging situations.